Hey guys, and welcome back to another video. So in today's video, we'll be looking into how you can create a carousel in your React based application. So for demonstrating carousel, I'll just take you to this website. It is a responsive Bootstrap carousel library, or the CSS module used for creating beautiful looking carousels, as you can see in here. So this is the carousel. The way of sliding in things within a specific section is known as carousel. So for that example, I've just shown you this. This is the carousel format, and for this for today's video, we'll be looking into how you can create a React component which can do almost similar things to this. So this is a pretty good format where you have events and some good CSS, various on click events as well, on section based on different specific carousels, right? As you can see, you can definitely use this. It is entirely up to your preference. This is a good website where you can create new different formats of carousel. So just for demonstrating you what is a carousel and how does it actually looks, this is the format. You can definitely go to this website and navigate to it. Now let's go to the code. This is not something which I'll be creating right now. I'll just create a simple or demonstrable React component for now. So let's just go to the code. So the component which we are going to build is in React, and as you might have known earlier, the basic procedure of going on with React is npx create React app and the application's name. This is how I usually start and make the changes accordingly for your component, right? So the method which I've used in is also similar. So there is only one actual component. I've removed all the rest of the things. This is actually VS Code editor which I'm using right now, and this is the folder structure. Over here you can see in the left hand side, this is the folder structure, and this is the public folder, source folder, and package dependencies. So the important one over here is the source folder. Within the source folder, you might have come across various JS files like app.js, app.css, and etc. I've just removed everything, and let's get into simple things right now, right? So there is already an index JS file when you get started with the boilerplate code of React. I've just removed app.js and app.css, so don't just get confused with it because it's nothing new. I've just made it simpler, right? So the component which I'm actually, or the code which I've written, is in index.js. so these are the dependencies, and this is the component, carousel, React Elastic Carousel, and it has some CSS to it, and this is an external library. So if you even get started from scratch and you want to install it from scratch, this library, React Elastic Carousel, which you can find over here. So as you can see, it is installed. So this code will be available in the description. So if you download it or via zip or clone it, you'll get this package already within it. So you don't need to install it from externally using npm method, right? So you can download it and get started with it. It will be available in the description. So this is the component which I'm using. This is the app component. Usually this should be a functional. This is a functional component, and this is the actual component which we are importing from this React Elastic Carousel library. And there is one another component which I'm using over here is items, item.js. So this is basically a style export for the div which I'm using in index.js, right? So this is a component which I've exported and imported in this format. This is a breakpoint array which tells you how the slider moves in which direction and what should be the width of it and things like that. Now this is our functional component which will return a fragment. So this is a fragment. Usually you might be thinking, what is this? It is empty, right? But this is a fragment component in React. So whenever you return something or a component, it should be wrapped within a single component or a div. So this is the fragment. For more information on fragments, I will link the documentation of it in the description. You can check that out. So this is our main component React, and we are just mentioning a parameter breakpoints, which is already being mentioned over here, and a simple h1. And this is the component which basically is like a card. So when you move on the card from left to right or right to left, whatever format you want, this is basically that which slides from one position to another. So this is pretty much of it. This component is only required, and rest all the functionality will be carried by this carousel wrapper, because we have wrapped that card format, which you will see in a minute, where you will see 1, 2, 3 and things like that. You can also keep some images within that. So but for now we'll just stick to this, and this is how we wrap the carousel component, and within that you have those divisions or slider cards within that. So this is the code for it, and let's just run this, or we can just npm start. Starting the development server, and you'll see things in a minute. So this is the output. So this is the card which I was talking about. So basically this component, this one, the card layout kind of format, where the one is 1, 2, 3 is written, is basically this item component. So we have written that over here, and the CSS has been input exported in this format. So you can use this because this is a division which is being used there, right? So you can use this, and you can export it and import it in this format and wrap it inside the carousel component. So this is the output. As you can see, you can just navigate to this in right to left and left to right format, and you can also add images to this. For this reference, I've just used letters, numbers, or whatever you want. But I have an example where you can use an image. So over here, this is a simple example file. There is no purpose of this for now. I've just created and for demonstration purpose. So this is like a state within a class component, and this is like a array of objects, and within this you can also mention a URL within that state. So an image will have a URL within that, and within that you can iter the array, the state basically, and you can use the image tag to show images within your carousel. So instead of showing some images like this, you can have a image within that with a predefined width and height, right? So this is how you can use a state in React where you will have a ID to that specific carousel slider, and the title or the URL, you can change this as per your reference. This can be a URL to your image, and you can use the image of the entire URL, and you can use that state within this items when you map. Basically what map does is that it will iter your objects in a loop format, and you can use the image tag like I've shown over here. As I've used a division, you can also use a image tag where you'll pass the source as that URL, so directly you'll get a image over there. So this is one of the format you can use for adding images to your carousel. So instead of numbers, you will have image, and you can slide in this manner. So as you can see, this carousel has a image layer behind it. So similarly, you can use that as I've mentioned in this format. Just don't forget to wrap the carousel component wherever you are using the carousel, right? So this is an example for image. You can try this out, and this is the example for the number which I have shown you over here, right? As you can see. So yep, the code and the necessary things will be available in the description. Please do check this one and try to examine yourself with images. So this was it for this video, guys. This is the component which we are using for creating carousels, and if you have any questions, queries and concerns regarding this video, please do mention in the comment. I'll be helping you out with that, and yeah, thanks for watching.